All right, folks, once again, I am Tom Downey. Go follow me on Twitter at WhatGoingDowney for more Cowboys coverage. Let's move then to the latest rumors around the Cowboys with an emphasis, of course, on free agency. I already saw this a ton in the comments section. What about the Cowboys and Eric Berry? Heck, Wyatt just put it in there. I'll give it 2 stars. I'm not quite sure you're going to see this one go down, but the Cowboys are looking in to Berry's medical history. That is the first step in terms of a research there, because the medical is a big, big red flag and giant question mark for Eric Berry, as I just saw someone put in the comment section. That heel, it's not right. He's played 3 games in the past 2 years. Now, when he's on the field, he's still a really good player. And from that point, I am intrigued by Eric Berry. But I'll make this note, as I did on Twitter, I kind of figure the Browns are just going to get Eric Berry. There's a John Dorsey connection there. I think it makes a lot of sense. So I am intrigued by Eric Berry, but the price does matter. The Cowboys are not going to go high. If I'm in charge, which obviously I'm not, I'm looking at a 1, maybe 2-year deal, limited guaranteed money with incentives to make it worth more, a lighter base salary. If he hits it, great. Then you're happy to pay him. If not, maybe not so much. Now, of course, the only reason we've been talking about safeties right now is because the Cowboys did not land Earl Thomas. We put this poll up on our channel. Should Dallas have given Earl Thomas a 4-year, $55 million deal? These are the poll results, at least when I grabbed them this morning. 29% said yes, 71% said no. There's no such thing as a unanimously accepted opinion, but that's pretty close, I think, for social media. So most of you think that the Cowboys should not have given Earl Thomas that deal, and I agree, and so too do the Cowboys. They were never in play at that amount of money. Now, there were some good comments. I want to shout out some of these here to just provide a little bit of an overview of how people thought, and a lot of these were liked on that poll post, by the way. Cole says, without a doubt, he would have improved the defense, but the cost was too great. I agree, Cole. I also agree with Gamer21514 Live. Too much money. I think that was the main issue there for the Dallas Cowboys. Matt S. with another more in-depth comment. He's not in his prime. He's getting old and has been injury prone. Would get better value with second-tier safeties and or drafting one. Stay tuned for that last part there, guys. We'll have some safety targets in free agency and for the draft later on the channel. Butchin the Gamer, who of course has the nice Timmy Turner reference there. We just recently came out of being in cap hell. I don't want to go through that again. Steven and Will McClay are taking the reins and running this franchise correctly. Makes a point to compare it to the Patriots, which is a little bit more of the Patriots' MO there. That you don't have to spend big in free agency. It's a little bit more cheaper and more ideally long-term to go about it that way and not throw money around in free agency. Robbie, though, and I want to provide avenues to both sides, that it's not different. That it's a little bit different here. That if he starts performing hella good for the Ravens, each one of you are going to regret passing on him, which very well might end up being the case. There's no playmaking safety. Lost some best receivers and goes on and makes a good point about DeMarcus Lawrence there. So a fair comment there from Robbie. And also from JRO, who says we need a playmaking safety. Again, the good news is, as much as we would have liked Earl Thomas, price was probably a bit too high. There are still several free agent safeties out there, like HaHa Clinton Dix, who we'll talk about later on in the week. We'll have a list of the top safety targets for the Cowboys in free agency, so stay tuned for that. Make sure you guys are subscribed and turn on notifications. You'll be notified the second that goes up. Back to free agency now. What about signing Golden Tate? I'm going to give this one just 1 star there. The caveat is, if Golden Tate, and his market isn't what I think he hopes it is, which is, I think, around the Cole Beasley market, if not higher, right? That if Tate can't find a player and he's getting $6 million, I think the Cowboys would offer Golden Tate the Cole Beasley contract. 3 years, $18 million. I think Golden Tate can do better. That's why it's just a 1 star. I could see the Patriots offering more money. Maybe the Pittsburgh Steelers, both those teams have been linked there to Golden Tate. I could see Tate getting $9 million from a team like the Patriots. So that's why it's only the 1 star there. With that said, as Cowboys Nation points out and Quentin McNeil say, I'd love to sign Golden Tate. And by the way, if I did sign Golden Tate for, let's just say, $6 million, I'm cutting Allen Hurns in a heartbeat. You don't need both. I know some of you guys like Allen Hurns, but you got to save money. You can almost, dollar for dollar, swap out Golden Tate for Allen Hurns. For me, that one's a bit of a no-brainer. So what would you guys pay Golden Tate per year? I have said it before. He is a Dak-friendly receiver. Gets open well, runs routes well, creates enough separation that it makes it easier for Golden Tate. Boom Awesome says Tate at 3 years, 18. Hell yeah. I'm on board, but I kind of think his market is going to come in a little bit higher. Let's talk trade now. How about Emmanuel Ogbah? Could he be a trade target for the Cowboys? Much like Golden Tate, I'm on board. Not sure the Cowboys are going to be just the one star there. Now, the Cowboys did once really want Ogbah, as I'm sure you guys have heard by now. He was going to be the pick in 2016. That was, the Cowboys had that written on paper. They were going to take him. Then the Browns took him. The Cowboys reset and took in, instead, Jalen Smith. Which has worked out pretty well in the end for the Cowboys. I think they won that draft pick. Now, the Cowboys have yet to show trade interest in Ogbah because I think maybe their evaluation has changed. I'm intrigued, but the production really isn't there. It's regressed each and every single season. And from the Cowboys' perspective, you do need some more offensive or more edge rushers, but I'm not sure they are convinced that Ogbah would be an upgrade over Taco Charlton. I think it would be. But I'm not sure the Cowboys feel the same way. Plus, with 1 year left on his deal, that typically isn't the Cowboys' MO. Now, I do think in the end you need some more edge rushers. So if you wanted Emmanuel Ogbah, what would you guys trade for him? Let me know in the comment section. I'm fifth rounder? Do they take that? I'm interested. Maybe a package Emmanuel Ogbah and Duke Johnson together and give up like a fourth or something. I'm intrigued by that. Not sure the Browns or the Cowboys are in the end, though. So not quite sure what will happen on that front. I like the idea of going after Emmanuel Ogbah. I like the idea of Duke Johnson. But we know the Cowboys. You can't just add every single player that we'd like. Some more free agency stuff here. How about re-signing DeMarcus Lawrence? I saw this point in the comment section, and I agree with you guys. Just get it done. Not that hard, right? Pay the man. 3 stars here. Again, I still think the deal gets done. I'm not panicking yet, but the longer it goes on, the more I go, God, could they botch it? That's like my worst fear, is that if something goes terribly wrong here, that it just does not work out. So DeMarcus Lawrence, again, took a pay cut. Or Sean Lee took a pay cut in part because he wants to pay for Tank. Lee, and he made this comment very openly, he knows how important DeMarcus Lawrence is. He's not dumb. He knows how much that matters to him. Now, the Cowboys, yes, they missed on Earl Thomas. I see some comments in here about projected contracts, and we'll get to that here in just a minute. But pay him. 5 years, $104 million. I think it gets it done. I really do. And if the Cowboys are being stingy, I know they want to maintain cap flexibility. But if you don't have DeMarcus Lawrence, who is your pass rusher? Who is the guy that can get you 10 sacks? Taco Charlton, Tyrone Crawford, Dorrance Armstrong. These guys are fine. I like Tyrone Crawford especially. They're not going to get the deal done. There's just no way. So it's not that hard, at least for me. Just pay DeMarcus Lawrence. He's worth the money right now. I see some of you guys throwing in $21 million. I'm fine with that one as well. Now, today's show, as it always is, brought to you guys by BetDSI, the internet's number one sportsbook. Head over to chatsports.com/bet. Use promo code COWBOYS120 for 120% deposit bonus. You put down $50, they're going to give you $60 for free. You guys will not find a better deal out there right now than once we get with March Madness and BetDSI. Chatsports.com/bet, promo code COWBOYS120. All right, some little more fun rumors, I think. Did Odell Beckham like the idea of joining the Cowboys? I'll give this one 3 stars. I pretty much buy it, but I'm not going to give it 4 because I don't want to give the indication that this could have happened. This was never going to go down. But Odell, he was intrigued by it before he, of course, got traded to the Cleveland Browns. Remember, Odell, he likes Dak and Zeke. I mean, those guys get along pretty well, and he gets to play the Giants twice a year. And it's a fun idea. It was never going to happen. Couple reasons. Number one, what are the Cowboys offering? You can build a package around Amari Cooper. I think the Giants wanted the draft picks, though. Well, that's kind of that one there. And then, of course, he wants to play with his buddy Jarvis Landry. That's a big reason why I think he ended up in Cleveland. So, yes, and I'll let you guys in on a secret. A lot of people around the NFL or players, they want to play for the Cowboys, too. It just depends on if the money's right, as we saw with Earl Thomas. Now, the Earl Thomas dream, that's dead. What's not dead and what is dead may never die, Sean Payton and the Dallas Cowboys. This rumor is never going to go away until he's with the Cowboys or, as even as we see right now, signs a massive deal with the Saints. The speculation between Sean Payton and the Cowboys will always be there. We're probably going to keep bringing back two stars. Okay, we're probably going to keep it at two stars there. The report from Clarence Hill is that Teddy Bridgewater has some fears about re-signing with the Saints because he doesn't know what's going to happen with Sean Payton, which I find very funny. But they've heard the rumors. Again, if and when Jason Garrett gets fired, Sean Payton is the number one name at that list for Jerry Jones in particular, because Jerry loves Sean Payton and he and Sean get along. Now, I don't know if it's actually going to go down. There's a lot of hurdles to clear. But who do you guys want as the next Cowboys head coach? I kind of figured here most of you will throw out Sean Payton. I think Lincoln Riley could be a target as well if we ever get to that point. And if the Cowboys struggle, well, we'll keep you guys covered here with plenty of rumors around that. But again, let me know in the comments section, who do you guys want as the next Cowboys head coach? Hey Cowboys fans, thanks for watching the Cowboys Report. If you haven't already, click right here to subscribe to our channel for all the best Cowboys coverage on the internet. That's news, rumors, highlights, mailbags, film studies, and a whole lot more. And I'm making your lives a little bit easier as well with the next Cowboys Report video right here.